Indonesia.
Wow, that was fun.
Wow, it's a year of excitement, Chinese festive season. And today we are so lucky and honored to have Helen and Aaron joining us for the Fengshui Insight Talk 2024.
It's been my pleasure and honor to speak alongside with you again.
Wow, I've been looking for 1 year for that. But before we go into you, Helen, Aaron, what is your view and take of 2024?
This is a year whereby, despite of whatever is going on,
while the economic conditions still remain pretty robust,
but we can slowly see the growth deteriorating, and as a result of that, we do expect the interest rates to be cut within this year, especially towards the second half. This will be the time very conducive for that, because of the declining interest rates environment will help the bond prices within the portfolio. But at the same time, we do look at the geopolitical tensions are happening around, and that has not changed from last year. The world is still watching very much closely with all of these events.
The problems of 2023 seems unresolved, and it seems to be getting into 2024. But interestingly is that 2024, the market has been talking about interest rate cut. In the aspect of the market uncertainty and the risk event itself, the traders and market, the investors, always looking for ways to hedge the market risk. And we are talking about the precious metal gold.
I have this as part of what I have written. We are very much in tandem, but I'll save it for my section later.
Wow, this is interesting.
And just to add a little bit more flavor, Aaron, we also aware that interest rate, you know, the reverse relationship with gold, together with the uncertainties in the market itself, gold seems to be one attraction that the market could be potentially looking into.
Actually, it's a very good point. You know, for gold, right, it is actually works very well within the portfolio because it offers an uncorrelated assets in terms of the returns. And as a result of that, it fits very nicely within the portfolio to hedge against unforeseen circumstances.
Hey, 大家吃吃吃,
So, Sam and Aaron, you've been talking about geopolitical. How about something closer to home? What about Asia?
Among the geopolitical events in 2023, we saw a bright spot in Asia.
Definitely, Sam. Japan is well represented in the land of the rising sun, partly because we see corporate restructuring and earnings are now improving this year. So we do see an up performance there as well.
We are seeing right now Japan is on a 34-year high.
On the contrary side of things, China has been on the reverse. It had actually an uneven recovery. In fact, the equities have already had a massive correction already. But what investors would like to see is the turnaround whereby the government policies will be more of a stimulus towards the monetary front and the fiscal.
For the start of 2024, you know, we have been hearing a lot of the positive news from China, you know, about the fiscal monetary policy or what they want to do to revive the China economy.
Hence, we still remain cautiously optimistic on that front while waiting for more of the signs from the government policies.
Let's campaign!
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 In fact, 2023 last year had actually an eventful year where US equities took the lead with the tech recovery as well. What are your thoughts?
For AI, semicon, tech stock, that have been the prominent leaders in 2023. But we also noticed in the last quarter of 2023, some other sectors also started to make a move. The utilities, financial, real estate.
Oh, so actually you see a bit of a recovery of the laggards are now improving on the more of a defensive quality.
Helen, this is the moment we have been waiting for. It's about you and the Fengshui.
This is so insightful listening to both of you. And I was just thinking, you know, the Dragon year is not just purely looking at the dragon. We also look at the elements that stand on top of the dragon element, which is the wood element. So you know, in Chinese metaphysics, right, when you look at the wood element, it is also the wealth element for the metal-related industry. So you both mentioned about gold earlier, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Ah.
So what is the gold going to represent in this year?
Having seen wood standing on top, it means the wealth element is being revealed. It's opportunities for us to consider investment in this area. Like you talk about hedging, right, against the risk. So this is one part that we can consider. Wood also represents system and structure. It also gives people like us an opportunity to think about restructuring ourselves, right?
Restructuring ourselves means upgrading ourselves through education?
Yes, yes, wood represents education. Wood is in fact an element that represents growth. Anything that has got to do with growth, longevity, education, learning, right? Food, agriculture, it's all wood related. Aaron, you talked about bonds earlier, and that reminds me of the earth element represented by the dragon this year. Earth element represents anything that can withstand the test of time. It means long term. We also look at it potentially being a storage. Those who are into accumulating assets, you know, in the longer term, this is perhaps a very good opportunity too.
We hope you find this insightful.
And I've enjoyed and learned so much of it.
And here's wishing everyone 龙转乾坤, 龙颂吉祥, 健康平安, 金玉满堂, 富贵有余, 步步高升, 万事如意,
整年好运一条龙。